20 when he became Britain's youngest band leader 60 years ago. The date was January the 31st, and that's the date he's chosen for his retirement, neatly wrapping up 6 decades devoted to his music. And he's rather tickled that after all this time, he's back in the charts, courtesy of the Jive Bunny mixes.
Come on, everybody!
First, his very special tune, In the Mood, found its way back to number one, a signature tune shared by Glenn Miller. Now, his March of the Mods is up there in the charts too. Quite an achievement, but then there have been many. The Queen made him a Lieutenant of the Royal Victorian Order, awarded him a Silver Jubilee Medal and the OBE. He's travelled the world several times and received enough awards and trophies to fill his study, 60 years worth.
People say to me, how is it you get going? Decade after decade, new ideas come in, new form of orchestration, so forth and so on. I said, well, I never rest on my laurels. It's a case of introducing new things, but not because it's number one that I will play it. Pardon me. I like to feel that the music is going to be wanted by the public at large.
And it always has been. He's immensely proud of the many stars he introduced to the business. Eamon Andrews repaid the compliment by honouring Joe twice on This Is Your Life. And Vera Lynn began her career with him too. There are thousands of press cuttings chronicling an incredible career. But he's still got one great ambition, to persuade the education authorities to go back to teaching children to dance. Not only because it's fun, but for the confidence and social benefits it brings.
When I go in front of that band, to me, that floor is there for dancing, unless we play concerts. And unless that is full, I have failed. So it's a case of, within virtually seconds, that floor has to be packed.
He's 80 now and unwell, so from next month, the band will go on without him. But he'll never be all that far away. Trisha Ingram's Thames Television.